Okay, so in this video, I'm going to show you guys the really simple and easy way to move a WordPress website from one server or installation to another one. It's really easy. It's actually the plugin we're going to use is a free plugin as long as your site is on the smaller side. If it's a bigger site, then you will need to pay for it. But I think it's a great tool. It's really easy to use, and it's a great way of moving your website. And you might want to do that, for example, if you built your website on your local machine on your Mac, and then you want to load it up to a live server. And I've got a video of how to install WordPress on your Mac and a video on how to install WordPress on your PC, and I'll link to those in the description below as well as at the top of this video. And it's my mission to help you guys out and to help you guys find out the best and easiest ways of building with and dealing with websites, because we all live busy lives and websites are really important thing to have, but we don't want the website to consume our life, especially if we're doing something else like running our own business, or if you're building websites for lots of other clients. You want to find, you know, the path of least resistance. And so that's my mission. And it's my mission with these tutorials too. So definitely, if you like this tutorial, give me a thumbs up. If you have suggestions on how I can improve it, or if you want to just tell me about how it helped you out, definitely leave those in the comments below. That will help me out and help me make better content in the future. So let's go ahead and get started. So this is a website that I created here. I'm currently testing the Themify theme. I'm going to have that review up soon. And so if I wanted to transfer this website to a live server or just any place else, here's how you do it. You go up here to your dashboard. And then we're going to go down to plugins and add new. And then we're going to search for a plugin. The one we're going to use is the all-in-one migration plugin. So I find what works best is just type in all and let it reload. And we get the all-in-one WP migration plugin. And then go ahead and click install now. And then after it's installed, click the activate button. And there we go. Now it's activated and ready to go. And it's created this new tool here on the toolbar. And so we can click on export to export this file. And it's got some other options here where you can replace certain parts of your website. So if you're changing your website's name completely and you want to replace all of the instances where you said, you know, website A and you're switching it to website B, you can do that here. I'm just going to leave it all alone. There's also some advanced options here. I'm just going to leave that alone, just keep it really simple. And then we're just going to do export to file, and it's going to allow us to download it to our computer. So give it a few moments to create the file. Okay, and then once it's created the file, you just want to click on this download, and it should have the name of your website. And then we can close this after it's downloaded. And then after it's downloaded, it's going to create this file here. It's going to have this .wpress suffix to it, and you definitely don't want to mess with that, so just leave that alone. And then what we can do is go to a fresh install of WordPress and upload that file. So let's go ahead and see how you do that. So I'm going to use Local by Flywheel, and I just did a tutorial on how to set up WordPress on your Mac with Local by Flywheel. And they're working on making this compatible with Windows. They haven't quite gotten there yet, but hopefully they'll have that soon because it is a ridiculously easy tool to use. I'm just going to go ahead and quickly create a new site. Okay, so now it's created my new site for me. I'm going to go to the admin panel of that new site. This is a completely fresh install of WordPress, and you want to make sure you have a completely fresh install or an install that you don't care about, because it's going to wipe everything out when you import the new file. So to do that, we're going to go to plugins, we're going to go to add new. We're going to install the all-in-one migration WP... What is it? The all-in-one WP migration plugin. I'm going to activate it. So this is my fresh install. You can see there's nothing else on it. And then we're going to go over here to import. I tried using the drag and drop method of just dragging the file over. It didn't work for me for some reason. So just go to import file, find the file on your computer. That's this one right here. Then it's going to upload it to your website. And it's just letting you know it's going to overwrite everything and basically erase your website with all the new information, which is what we want to do. And this is really important here. It says you must save your permalinks structure twice. So you can click on that. It's going to ask us to re-log into our website because it's basically a new website. So you'll need to use the credentials of the website that you transferred. And then see where it says post name here. This is how I recommend in setting up your WordPress website, is to have it set to post name. We want to click on save changes. I'm not too sure why it says you need to make sure you save it twice, but I'm just going to go ahead and click save it twice. And there we go. And now if we go and visit our website, we can see that we've now transferred this website to the new domain. And there you go. It's just that easy to move your website from one place to another. So if you found this helpful, definitely give me a thumbs up. Let me know in the comments below how I can improve this video, or that you just thought it was helpful. And if you're looking for, you know, a new theme, or if you're looking for new hosting for your website, definitely check out my reviews of themes and hosting companies, because I want to help you guys find the best tools that are going to make building your website easy. Because what's the most important thing is your time, and using the right tools can really save you guys a lot of time. So I hope you found this helpful. Be sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel and visit me at realwebsitehints.com. Thanks for watching.